You're making this more difficult than it has to be. If you just cooperate and answer the questions, you can go home. Maybe get some sleep. How are you feeling? I know it's been a long night for you. You look like you could use some rest.
Yeah, I'm pissed. I'm
feeling pretty fucking pissed off right now, if I'm honest. I'd like to smash everything in this room.
Exactly. That's how I feel every day.
Depends on how much you like the furniture.
I didn't think that was funny, in case you were waiting for me to laugh. Look, I know what you must be going through. Really, I do. But I could use your cooperation.
Well, I'd appreciate if you'd fuck off.
Bigby, I've been interviewing people all night.
And it's probably not the first time you've heard it today. Maybe you should take a hint. You're a detective, right?
Well, you stonewalling me like this isn't helping either of us, so why don't you cut the shit and...
Fuck off. Sit your ass down. Fucking interview interrogating me for what?
I'm trying to help you, Bigby.
Like, what did I have to do with this? I ain't kill her.
What is it with you cops? Always trying to empathize with people. I know this must be hard for you. Do you? Do you fucking know? Have you had a friend killed and their head left at your fucking doorstep? No, didn't think so. Your nose is bleeding.
Ugh.
Are you okay? You don't look so good. Detective Brannigan?
I'm Detective Brannigan.
Yeah, cocaine?
I know. I just said that.
She on the cocaine?
Is there something?
Do you hear that? Please. Please.
Oh, that sound?
I'm sorry. Just make it stop, please.
What the hell?
We have to go, now.
What did you do to her?
She'll be fine. It's just a memory wipe spell. Very expensive, but it works. The whole station will forget the last 24 hours, and everything they saw at the Woodlands. Well, hurry up!
Bailing me out.
Certainly. We found Tweedledee chained up to a post. That was your doing, correct?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know why you detained him. Dee was at the trip trap when Snow was left at the Woodlands, so he couldn't possibly be involved in this mayhem. Bluebeard's currently interrogating him, and he hasn't said anything useful.
There's two of them. Dee and Dunn. They've been snooping around every crime scene I've looked at.
That doesn't mean they're necessarily involved in the murders.
Yeah, they probably killed Lawrence. Oh, actually, no, Lawrence is alive. No, this is a different story. Completely messed up. I played the first episode on my own.
I know what you're thinking, Bigby.
No, it's probably different.
It's been one full night and a slice of morning. And I already miss her, too. I never get more homesick than when one of us dies. And now, were it to be Snow, I've never been good with these sorts of things. I just can't believe this is really happening.
Yeah, it's hard.
Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused. Did she, give any indication to what she was thinking? When you saw her last, I mean. I don't know why, but I'd like to know that she was... I guess fine, I suppose.
Yes, she gave an indication she was pissed at you. By saying that she was pissed at you.
At me?
She was frustrated with the whole fucking system. Tired of having to turn Fables away. It wore her down.
I don't know what else to say, Bigby. We have to put an end to this. It's been 2 murders in as many days. If we don't unearth our culprit, and soon, there will likely be another on our doorstep tonight.
I'll get it done.
Please, Bigby. For Miss White.
I got it.
God damn.
Write to an attorney.
That's not a very good answer, is it?
Come on. Just tell me what I want to know.
It will make things a lot less painful for you.
Yeah, I'm gonna make sure I get this right.
Oh, were you planning on using that? I just thought you really liked rubbing your little sword. What the hell do you think you're doing?
Hello, Ichabod. Sheriff.
Bluebeard.
I was just chatting with our new friend.
You were supposed to wait for us to get back. I told you, if you want to be involved, you will do things my way. No violence!
Whatever you say, Ichabod.
Hello, Bigby.
I want answers, Dee.
Oh, goody. I thought you wanted questions, and I was having so much trouble thinking of any good ones. Though I'd settled on, how's your head?
You see what I've been dealing with? What are you going to do about this, Bigby?
Do you think this is a joke? Yeah, Snow exactly. White is dead.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you.
You were with me when it happened, dummy.
I still have questions for you, Dee.
Oh, sounds like a personal problem.
This is ridiculous.
Back in the alley, you mentioned your employer. Who is it? Who are you working for?
Why? You looking to change your occupation?
I'm not fucking around here, Dee. All right, Dee. Let's get to know each other.
Oh, no, you're gonna hit him. You're trying to do good cop. I guess.
Fuck, Bigby. Don't make me look at that. Just put that away. Please.
Yeah, if you don't tell me who did this, I'll make sure you end up the same way. Dead on your doorstep. Got it?
I told you, I didn't kill her, and I don't know who did.
Just tell me who your employer is.
I'd like to help you. But I can't. My brother and I, we got a thing about loyalty. We do our job and we keep our mouths shut. If we don't hold up our end, we don't get paid.
Your brother? Where was he last night?
I can't say. He could have been anywhere.
Take your best guess.
He didn't do it, if that's what you're thinking.
Then where is he?
No, I'm not sending you after my brother. Look, I answered your question. Can I get my stuff back now?
What did you find on her?
Oh, nothing of consequence, really.
Are you done?
You always carry this much cash?
I've got a lot of laundry to do this week. What's it to you?
So where's your brother?
Look, mate, I'd like to help. I would, but I can't tell you where he is. Last time I saw him, we split up and I went to find Faith. I don't know where he is now, but he didn't kill anybody.
You mentioned Faith?
Look, I went to her apartment. That's no secret. You saw me.
No, there's more to it. You said you were trying to find something.
All right, Dee. What did you want from Faith?
Sorry, I can't help you. I'm not saying any more about it.
You just carry this around?
Always handy that way.
Now you want some? It'll get you to talk.
That couldn't hurt, I guess.
Find out what happened to those girls? To Snow White?
Let me handle this. Come on, Dee. What did you want from Faith? Sweet girl like her.
Sweet? You think that girl was sweet? She was a fucking thief. Fucking sweet. Faith was plenty of things, but that ain't one of them.
What did she steal?
I don't know. Just some dumb thing my boss was after.
Your boss?
Uh-oh.
Well, that brings me back to my first question. Who are you working for?
You're gonna get me in trouble, Bigby. I can't answer any more of your questions.
Jesus Christ. Alright, let me give you a cigarette. Cigar.
I'm saving that.
You want it?
Here.
Yeah, all right. Want to see
take the
a
rest
trick.
Of it? It's like no. Fucking asshole.
Why don't you just tell me who you're working for?
Look, you're not a bad guy, despite what Beauty says about you. At least you're not a total bastard, anyway. But I just can't give you that information.
There's no way Beauty would associate with a scumbag like you.
What's wrong with me? You're telling me I ain't pretty enough? Yeah, we're real close.
I thought this was supposed to be a murder investigation, but you're treating this guy like a fucking house guest, Bluebeard! And not getting any answers from him this way. Snow White is dead. One of us. And you're going to let this ignorant shit walk out of here in one piece. Out of my way! I'll show you how it's done!
What the fuck? What do you think you're doing?
Teaching him a lesson. Now pay attention.
Stop this right now!
You enjoying yourself?
Immensely.
Out the whole time.
Snow.
Okay. So all that was for nothing. Bruh. Tell King presents a telltale story. I think I got a mosquito bite. My feet is itchy. The Wolf Among Us. Alright, so now we gotta go to the mirror. Alright. Episode 2, Smoke and Mirrors. God, he just moved to the other side. Oh, he's actually looking, but he's like,
what the hell was going on down there, Bigby? Abusing a prisoner like that.
Yeah, I thought you were dead.
I thought you were dead, Snow.
And that makes it okay?
Yeah.
I hope it was worth your time.
Where the hell have you been all night, Snow?
I was working on this case.
After a conversation in the taxi last night, I got a call from Toad. He said his son found a body. We thought it was Faith at the time. Getting her back here wasn't easy, but hopefully we'll find something on her to help us track down the killer, or at least to figure out who she is.
I should have been there, Snow.
I tried calling the business office, but there was no answer. I couldn't find you, or anyone, so I took care of it.
Snow?
What is it?
I'm glad you're not dead.
Me too. I just want to get to the bottom of this. I just feel like...
What is it?
I feel responsible in a way. She looked just like me. And maybe that's why she was killed.
Snow, it's not your fault.
But she looked just like me. That can't be a coincidence. We just have to find out who did this. And why she was glamored to look like me. I mean, that's what it is, right? So, what's our next move?
We just keep doing what we've been doing.
Yep.
We do our jobs.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm supposed to do what? Sit around the business office twiddling my thumbs, waiting for the big bad wolf to solve all my problems?
That's not what I meant.
Well, then what did you mean? I told you, I'm tired of sitting around. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once.
I'm not yours to lose.
I'm sorry. I know it's dangerous, but I'm not helpless. I can take care of myself.
Okay, whatever you say.
I've been doing it for centuries.
Whatever you say.
TJ is waiting inside. He was so freaked out last night, he wouldn't tell us much. Even now, he just stops talking altogether after a certain point. He's pretty shaken up, though, so try not to be too, you know.
Myself.
Right.
Breaking points.
TJ's over there. I don't know if you want to talk to him first or after, but let me know when you're ready to see the body. I want to be there. Bufkin, do you have a second?
Of course, Miss Snow.
Okay, let's go talk to him.
Oh, that's enough. Amira, vanish! Cancel!
What the hell are you doing?
What? I wasn't touching nothing.
What's going on?
You're on thin ice, Toad. Don't test me.
No need to get all worked up. It ain't a big deal.
TJ. It's all right. Are you ready to talk to Mr. Wolf? It's okay.
Are you okay?
Go ahead, TJ.
I go swimming at night sometimes, in the river.
Damn,
I wasn't doing anything bad. I promise.
Of course you weren't.
We know you're a good kid, TJ.
Just tell me what you saw.
I was there, under the big blocks, and I heard noisy feet. And when I hear that, I'm supposed to go underwater and stay real still and quiet.
Bruh.
That's right, son.
That's not telling us who you saw.
Then I saw...
There you go.
I saw the lady.
Careful, Bigby.
I wasn't.
Oh my gosh.
I know.
The lady fell in, but she didn't have her head on. I thought she was gonna pull me down too. Cause she had rocks on her feet and she kept falling down in the dark parts.
Cinder blocks tied to her ankles. Is there more, TJ?
Is it true? You know when people are lying? I heard you could do that. That's why you're the sheriff.
Please tell the truth. Is there something else?
Please, don't be mad.
What is it, TJ?
I didn't stay under the water.
What?
I know I'm supposed to, but I was scared, and I went to the top again. I couldn't help it!
I gave you very specific rules. You have to stay quiet and out of sight or bad things can happen. I told you!
You're not in trouble.
Like Ellie's not.
Not this time, Toad.
So you didn't stay underwater?
I don't know if anyone saw me, but someone said, stop laughing. And then I was scared, and I went under for as long as I could.
Wait, you heard someone?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell us before?
Were those the same words they used? Stop laughing? Try to remember exactly what they said.
They said, stop laughing at me.
Do you know whose voice it was?
No.
Did you hear anything else?
No!
No!
Bigby, he's frightened.
Did you see who it was?
I don't know! I'm sorry. After I came up again, there was no one there. And I ran home, that's all. I promise! I want to go home.
Okay, you can go.
Thank you, TJ.
Okay, son.
You did a good job, kid.
Come on.
Right. You'll remember that. Mm-hmm.
That went about as well as I expected.
You
want to go look at the body now?
No. So now this time we do in a minute.
In a minute.
Then we go to the mirror.
When you're ready.
Get this fable book. See what the hell he wanted. What are you talking to him for?
Hey, mirror.
Hello, Bigby. Nice to see you.
What were you showing Mr. Toad and his son?
Cinderella selling shoes, Rapunzel, Rose, and of course there's you. And I can't help note that you did not rhyme. Do try to stick to the rules next time.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay, so we're good now. I can talk to Snow. Where's she at? Oh, with Monkey Man.
Snow's perfume. And acids. Maybe this has been harder on him than I thought.
Good.
So, check out anyone who fits that profile. You might start with Bluebeard.
Right away, Miss Snow.
Are you ready to examine the body now?
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness! I almost forgot.
Come on.
The Wishing Well Chamber. Jeez. Imagine falling in there. Oh my gosh.
Never seen her face before now.
It's just a body, Snow. If you can't do this...
No, I'll be fine. I want to be here. The glamour is so effective, it's invasive. But just do what you need to do. Check her mouth. There might be a ribbon in there, like before. Anything?
Nothing.
Can you close her mouth?
Jesus Christ.
Thanks.
Looks just like Faith's did.
But there was nothing in her mouth this time. Do you think it was done by the same person?
Hard to tell. Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
No. He said he wanted to run more tests. That's weird. I don't wear a brooch like that.
Maybe it really belonged to her. Not part of the glamour.
Looks like something from the homelands. Bufkin, do you recognize these symbols?
No, nothing I've seen before.
Track marks.
She used Mundi drugs?
Looks that way. Pretty heavily, too. I hear they only go for the legs if they've used up the veins in their arms, or if they're trying to hide the marks.
Wait. If the glamour is supposed to make her look like me, shouldn't it be concealing things like track marks? That brooch, too. Why would it change everything else?
It might be a cheap one, just to get the job done.
The witches upstairs know what they're doing, that's why they cost so much. Unless someone is making glamours illegally?
It's not technically illegal, miss. It's not encouraged, for sure, but there aren't any laws specifically forbidding it.
So there's some sort of black market for glamours?
One would assume so. I imagine anyone with access to the proper books and training could theoretically produce a glamour.
Yet another thing to worry about. Black market or not, it's a pretty good match. Look at that. The buttons aren't exact either. There's an extra one here.
Rope marks.
She was tied up?
They tied cinder blocks to her ankles, so she would sink.
Oh.
Her fist is clenched.
So she fought back?
No marks on the knuckles.
Oh.
Maybe she was grabbing something?
Maybe. What are you doing?
Only way to find out.
Jesus, baby. What is it? Flowers.
Yeah. You're right. These buttons are wrong. I wonder...
What?
Snow. I need to open her coat.
Bigby, just let me.
It's not you, Snow. It's just a body.
Sorry, that took longer than expected. What have you found out?
I haven't finished yet.
Well, get on with it then. We can't waste too much time here. The killer might be preparing another attack as we speak.
We should keep going.
I'll get that pocket.
What is that?
It's your perfume.
How do you know what perfume I wear?
You can't fool this nose. Also, I saw the bottle on your desk. Looks like someone picked it out for her.
So, someone gave her instructions. Things like this before. It's definitely magic, though witches don't usually craft objects these days.
I don't think it's wise to fool around with that. It's some kind of black market magic. Who knows what it could do? We should have it looked at, just to make sure it isn't dangerous. Don't you think?
Will you keep quiet?
What? Dick, anyways.
There's something in here.
How do we open it?
I think I can figure it out. Something to do with these rings here.
What? No. Stop. Okay. Oh, okay. So maybe like a horse. Or something like that. There we go. Oh, a deer.
A deer? What does that mean? Oh.
See, what's the hair?
Is that...
It's your hair.
Why is she mad as shit about it? Someone's been stalking me. Someone said shh and just ran.
Someone must have taken this from my apartment. I noticed it was missing, but I didn't think. This was the last picture I had of Rose and me. My sister and I don't talk much anymore. Who did this, Bigby?
She's a troll?
You gotta be kidding me.
The fuck? Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, that helps explain the glamour. Kind of. Who is she? That wasn't there before. Who do you think she is? I don't know many trolls, I'm afraid.
Should have left them all back in the homelands.
You don't mean that, do you?
Maybe Holly knows.
The owner of the Trip Trap? No, she looks a little... Oh, no.
What is it?
It's not Holly, it's... her sister, Lily. She was reported missing, but I guess it just slipped through the cracks.
We have to go tell Holly.
Right. Who knows? She might know something about this. Who Lily was seeing.
Well, certainly another troll.
We should go.
You can't go out there.
Why not?
It's too dangerous. Someone tried to kill you. Bigby, you can't let her go out there with you. You'd be putting her life at risk.
Snow wants to come with me. I'm not gonna stop her.
But...
We should leave now. You ready?
Yeah.
You know, she ain't staying. You doing some evil shit. I don't know what's going on with you. I don't like Crane. Asshole.
This whole thing is complete bullshit.
This is Terry Bogard head
of. I mean, what's his job, really?
To keep shit from reaching the Woodlands. Jack, I don't know where they are.
You're a bar. You're supposed to have darts around.
And I normally do, but who knows where the fuck they went to after...
Uh-oh, big boss.
Come on, Holly. I need entertainment. This'll do.
Okay, I know. Just relax. I'm not here to start anything.
Okay.
Miss White, I heard you had kind of a strange morning.
It's been kind of a strange morning for everyone, I think.
Every time I see this guy, he seems to lose weight. It's amazing. It really is. He loses weight and yet somehow keeps all the muscle.
Jack.
Wolfie, my dear, how are you? Because, you know, we were just talking about you. All of us. At the bar, here.
I just need to talk to Holly. Privately.
All right, just give us a second first. I'm dying to hear about the body that came out of the East River this morning. It was a fable, right? Oh, everyone knows.
Tweedledee was just here.
You said it looked like Snow White.
What the hell? Crane.
Sorry.
Tweedledee said you arrested him for no earthly reason. Kept him locked in the cellar all fucking night. He said you tortured him. Which, I don't know, that seems like a breach of your legislative duties. Maybe. Come on.
I
can't be so dumb as to.
Jack, find the off button. Now.
What is it with you two? You and Gran are all, let's get a posse together when there's no one around. But as soon as the big bad wolf walks in, your tails go between your legs.
Sounds like my family.
He fucking maimed you. Aren't you pissed?
Oh, when we want to do something.
Got your nerve. What happened?
Yeah, the camera turns
what
on.
What happened?
Tails between
I'm
your
tired
legs.
Is what happened.
Tired of what?
Of trouble, Jack. I'm sick and tired of trouble. I don't want any more. So just stop revving his motor or wait outside or fuck the hell off. I don't care which.
Yeah, I'm thinking
Jack.
What? Bigby, look. Two fables are dead. And shit, Gren's sister...
Holly's sister.
Holly's sister has been missing for what? A few days now? And we haven't heard word one about it from anyone. Hey, easy! Ah, fuck!
Fuck off.
What'd I do?
Ah! Go fuck on up a beanstalk, Jackie boy.
Gren, you gotta learn some new lines. Let me tell you.
All right, then. Actually, have there been any updates?
I don't know how to say this to you, Holly. The woman we found in the river.
Who was it?
You know who it was.
Damn.
God fucking damn it! Of course, the dear princess, Snow fucking White, is all safe and sound.
You asshole.
Where were you when we reported this weeks ago, huh? Where are you when we ever fucking need you? If you'd give 1 ounce of a shit about her, about any of us, she might have been saved. She might have been cared for. She might have been...
This damn Latino evil ass. Damn, bro. Yeah, give her some room.
All right. Clear out. Give her some room. I ain't leaving her with you. No way.
Okay, controller. Thanks. Ruining the moment,
Holly.
Get the fuck out of my bar.
Damn.
I just want.
It should have been you. It should have been you, and it wasn't.
Fuck the police coming straight from the underground signal.
We recovered this from her personal effects. I thought you might like to have it.
I didn't know she still had this. The copper was from a dwarf mine.
That was decent of you.
Gren.
Yeah?
Take off for a bit, would you?
Are you sure?
I don't know that much about her life. Honestly, we didn't talk often. She was lost here, in the city. She just got swept away by it.
Do you have any idea why she'd be glamored as Snow White?
What? Oh, God. I'm sorry. That was probably about... She was hooking to pay down debt. It ate me up to see her that way. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie. Mm. The owner, Georgie, with all his fucking fees, it's a crock of shit. That's how they kept her under their thumb, really.
Holly, it's okay.
Puddin' and Pie, huh? What do you know about the place?
It's a real garbage dump.
We can just go check it out. We've got a lead. Maybe we can take it from here.
Lily.
Thanks for everything, Holly. Is there anything we can do to...
No. No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
It's not charity. It's looking up for our own.
Is she... Where is she?
She's at the business office. She's taken care of.
I'm gonna have to go down there and get her. Fuck.
Please, we can handle the funeral arrangements.
No. It's a formality with trolls. We burn our dead by sunrise or... I don't know. Some old world shit will fuck your soul up.
Of course.
Okay. Good.
Let's go down to the business office and start making the necessary preparations, all right?
Did you smile?
That club?
I'll go down there now. See what I can find out from the owner.
You were good with her. I'm impressed. Really, thanks. It just made everything easier.
Yeah, no problem. Damn. Oh, that was from the other fight. Sisters. Pudding and Pie.
Oh, Sheriff, what a nice surprise. I'm not sure I've seen you here before. You're always welcome, of course. Is it business or pleasure?
I've got some questions for Georgie.
Straight to business this time, then.
Yeah?
You're in luck. He's here. Come on.
Oh, do you have to go there often, I guess?
I should warn you that Georgie does not like to be bothered when he's working. And he's in kind of a mood right now.
Yeah,
I don't much care how he feels about it.
It's urgent.
Well, you two will get along just swimmingly. Welcome to the Pudding and Pie, where we cater to the diverse tastes of the Fable community. Your pleasure is our pleasure.
Did you know Lily? She worked here?
My lips are sealed.
Oh my god.
You'd better ask Georgie.
God damn it. Cuppy Fry. Cuppy Fry. Cuppy Fry. Cuppy Fry. Oh my gosh. I hope I don't have to block this out because I don't really want to do that.
What do you think you're doing?
If I just take some
monetization. You look like you're trying to take a shit. Who's gonna want that? No one's gonna want that.
Nice place.
You do have a sense of humor. That's good. Good lad.
It's your face. You have to smile.
Okay.
Oh,
I just want to look around.
We're closed. Keep dancing, you. I didn't say stop. For fuck's sake. You, stay right there. Don't even think about sitting down.
You, Georgie.
Brilliant deduction, Sheriff. What do you want, then? You here for a little taste? Tell you what, come back after midnight, maybe. I can hook you up. Or, knowing you, she's probably not quite your style. You'd prefer someone who can take a bit of a beating.
I'm not here for that.
Oh, I'm not here for that. Just stopped in for the chips, then?
Yeah.
Jesus, Bigby, you're so corny. I love it, though. No, seriously, I love it. Okay, all right, Sheriff. Just fucking with you. Look, I know why you're here.
Yeah, dude. Are you sure?
Listen, Sheriff. Around here, we can't afford to wait for you and your swanky pals to take an interest. We have to look out for each other. When shit happens, I hear about it. Especially if it concerns my livelihood.
In that case, I assume you knew Lily was glamoured.
Of course she was, you daft git. She was a troll.
No. I mean glamoured to look like another fable.
Yeah? Well, so what? Who gives a toss? People get up to all kinds of things when nobody's watching.
It's sick.
Ha! That's quaint. Especially coming from you.
The 13th floor would never provide a glamour like that. Strictly black market stuff.
Ooh, black market, is it? How exciting. This is exactly what I would expect from a thug like you. Storm in, throw around a bunch of accusations, try to scare people. But you've got fuck all to back it up. And we're all just meant to jump any time the wolf shows his teeth. It used to be something, you know.
Nothing to back it up? Well, what the fuck is this, then?
Get that out of my face.
I found it on Lily's body, and it's definitely a back alley job. Where did she get it?
You've got this all wrong. If Lily was doing a special glamour, it wasn't for me. For fuck's sake, I want that kind of heat.
Who was she doing it for, then?
She had clients, Bigby. Maybe one of them was into it. A lot of fucked up people in Fable Town.
Like who?
Try looking in the mirror. Anyway, now what to do with me? Go on, then.
Turn that shit off.
You gonna hit me? Go ahead. That's what you wanna do, right?
Tell me what I wanna know, or I'll shut this whole place down.
Fucking idiot.
Oh, no, fuck! You! Take your sad fucking face where I can't see it! Bloody bastard fucking shit! You proud of yourself, mate? Proud of your little mess? Fuck's sake. Fuck off, Hans.
God damn.
Hold on a minute. Hans, is it?
Hans just cleans up and provides a little muscle when we need it. He's not gonna know anything about the girls and their clients or any of that. No one knows. Don't you get it? It's by design. Discretion is our guarantee, right? And the way we guarantee that is that no one knows anything they don't have to know, including me. I cover my eyes and take my cut. End of story.
Why not look it up?
What's that?
Isn't there a little book with all the stuff about the girls and all that written in
it? You're a fucking moron.
Show me.
There is no book. And as for you, Hans, we need to work on your communication skills.
and have a fairly good idea where to start.
Ain't about to beat him with it? The
that's
fuck?
My personal property. Sure, go ahead. Do what comes naturally.
He's not gonna hit the thing, is he? No. I don't want
to. Tell me about
it.
The book.
You haven't got the slightest clue about anything.
I want to destroy
hey,
it.
Hey now!
Cut the crap, Georgie. I want the book Hans is talking about.
Hans is confused. Again. Don't even think about it.
Look, Georgie, why don't you just tell me where the book is?
Can we please not go round and round about this? There's no book. End of story. Do not touch that.
Oh my god, how much stuff are you going to destroy, bro? Just hand it over.
There's still time for you to just cough it up.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but there's no handy magic book with everything you want to know jotted down inside.
That's a silly wish there was.
Maybe it would get you off me back.
Oh, I was right there.
Well, well, what's this? Looks like a floor safe.
I wouldn't know. It was here when we moved in. I don't have a key to it. Sheriff, will you come on? For fuck's sake, I've got to open up in a few hours.
Yeah, I don't want to beat your ass, but just give me the goddamn book.
Give it to me.
You're a big bad bastard. We get it. Everyone's guilty. We fucking get it. Jesus, you're killing me. I'm begging you. I'll pay you.
Two women are dead.
Then quit being a bloody idiot. Come on, Nate. Leave it. There's nothing there for you.
You might want to stand back.
Oh, he's actually going to destroy it.
All right, all right, all right.
Good, because on the other playthrough, I might just destroy everything.
Bloody come on, men. Prick. Once again, don't get your hopes up. There's nothing in here that'll tell you anything. But it's a kick to the balls for me and my club, so we can be happy about that.
All right.
Here, this is Lily's last entry. So tell me, Georgie, who's this Mr. Smith?
Oh, dear. I'm afraid it might be a fake name, Bigby. Secrecy is sort of how this all works. Even Hans knows that.
What's 207? Room number?
I don't fucking know. Millimeters, maybe?
Don't bullshit me, Georgie. This is your book. Your girls.
I'm not their fucking secretary. I give them a stage. I give them music. I provide an erotic venue to attract and retain clients. But let's be clear on something. The girls make the arrangements with their clients, not me. The girls. They're the ones with the Mr. Smiths and Joneses and Mr. X types. Whatever happens outside the club, that's on them. I log the business, take my cut, and I'm out. Now, I've had quite enough of you and your bullying. Excuse me while I call your superiors to make a complaint.
I didn't destroy anything. Why are you going to complain? All right.
Hello, business office.
Been busted open. Broken open, but there isn't even a lock. Faith, thanks for covering for me tonight. Let's talk before you go over to the apartment. Lily. Looks like they both saw one of Lily's clients.
Uh-oh.
Lipstick, lip gloss, compact, glitter. Faith.
So what's this? You just pick up everything else? Okay.
Excuse me.
I heard you out there. I don't remember ever seeing you here before.
I didn't have a reason to come here before.
I do now.
Yeah. So. You're trying to place me. They used to call me the Little Mermaid. Once upon a time.
You have legs. Kind of glamour?
No, they're real. Do you like them? They cost me a lot. My name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions.
Of course you do. I don't have answers. You'll have to find those yourself.
I need to know about one of Lily's clients, calling himself Mr. Smith, apparently.
We can't talk about work.
Damn.
This is a murder case.
I mean, can't.
What do you know? It's July.
His lips are sealed.
And we're playing
discretion
this in July.
Discretion is a guarantee.
I don't give a damn.
I don't give a damn about your guarantee. I need you to cooperate.
Exactly. Give me a fucking answer. See that?
This is what I need to know about. Lily's exactly. Last entry. Who's Mr. Smith? Where's room 207? I have to know.
These lips
are sealed. It's like, no.
Sheriff Wolf, would you like to make an appointment with me?
Sure.
Okay. What would I need to do?
So you can speak the truth.
I need 150. It's not good to be short.
No.
I don't have it.
I ain't giving you shit.
Wait here for a second.
Think I'm gonna give money to you, woman? Tired of giving money to people. Nah, I'm good.
Not 207?
You'll think of something.
The Open Arms. This is where they met.
Enjoy your stay. I hope you find what you're looking for.
Made them cry. Got some too. I mean, that's the usual. Sometimes you can't get a girl, you just go and do that. Costs more money, but fuck it. Nowadays, girls don't value you or towards anything. Let's look at soda machine.
Yeah. Shit. Kill ya.
I'd be drinking that shit out every day. What am I use the phone for? No. That shit.
Want it by the hour or for the whole night?
beauty.
I work here, okay? I work the front desk. It's to help pay rent. So, now you know. I know I should have told somebody, but Beast would lose his mind if you knew. Beast is a proud man, Bigby. He wants to do right by me, and he just couldn't handle it if he knew I had to do this so we don't get evicted.
You should really tell Beast.
So he's supposed to get a job or to get checked out or something?
I will. I just need to in my own time. By the way, thanks for covering for me. So, what are you doing here? Oh, you have a key.
Someone else was murdered last night.
I heard.
The victim was someone who worked at the Pudding and Pie. Lily. She, come around here ever?
Oh, yes. The troll. I did see her. I mean, you know, we never really spoke, but she came off a tad intimidating.
Ever see Lily with someone here? Maybe on a job?
Sometimes, but nobody I've recognized. I haven't worked here that long, though.
How about a room register? Or someone named Mr. Smith?
That's all we get here. Smiths, Jones, or Johnsons. I think the last ones are jokes.
Ever meet a girl named Faith? Or just maybe hear that name?
I might have. I don't know. By the end of the night, it's kind of a blur with all the names. Tara, Brandy, Amber, Heather... Sorry.
Okay, random people, yeah.
I talked to Tweedledee earlier today. He mentioned you in passing. Do you know him, or his brother?
I took out a loan. For back pay. It was like our third notice. And ever since then, those annoying freaks have been pestering me for the money, plus interest.
Why take out a loan from those two?
It was from the crooked man.
Beauty.
You don't know how desperate I was, Bigby. I had nowhere else to go.
Woodsman?
Look, if this ever happens again, come see me or Snow first, all right?
I tried.
Have you seen Snow White down here? Or maybe somebody glamored as her?
You know, it's funny. I did see someone who I thought looked a lot like her, but she didn't say anything when she saw me, even though she knew that I saw her. I just assumed it wasn't Snow and went about my business.
Thanks.
Wait. It'll be better if anyone sees you that they at least see you with me, so they know that I didn't let you just wander around by yourself. 5 minutes. Please.
We'll see, Beauty.
Just be ready to act like I'm trying to kick you out.
That won't be hard.
Can I get a fresh set of towels?
I assume you'll be filing some kind of an official report or something. Which is fine, it's just that I was wondering if I need to be in it. Do you have to mention my name? I mean, it's not like Beast would ever see your report. It's just...
Don't worry about it. The less I have to write down, the better.
Thanks. I appreciate it. Well, here we are. Which one was it?
You checked 204. Damn, you can actually hear them smashing. What the fuck? Wow.
Get health inspectors through here very often?
I don't know. What do you think?
Okay.
Never sure why they have desks in a place like this.
Finding what you're looking for?
I wasn't expecting much in here.
But isn't this why you're here? Why you have the key?
No. The key was just to be sure I found the right hotel. This isn't the room Lily was using.
Oh.
It tricked me. Then you just disappear.
So, are we done now?
No. The room they met in was 207.
Oh my gosh. 203's busy in there. Alright, going 207, let's go. Knock. Nothing. Alright, let's go in.
You have keys to these rooms?
I thought you had a key.
Not to this one.
Hold on, Bigby. I can't just let you go into any room you want. Seriously, what if someone found out? I could get into a lot of trouble.
You have to let me in there. This is the room, 207.
But I...
This is the room Lily was in.
Ugh, fine.
How did she just have the key, man?
Well, that's weird. This key is supposed to open every room in the building, but it's not working.
Beauty!
Ah, shit.
Beast?
Bigby? How could you do this to me?
No, sweetie, no. Wait a minute.
How could you do this? We've been together through everything. I took care of you. I love-
It's not what you think. Please.
You're cheating on me! With him?
No, Beast. I promise I'm not. I'm helping him. That's all.
I'll bet! I'm sure you help each other just great!
Beast, stop this. Right now. This isn't the way to handle things.
What do you know? You don't have anybody! What the fuck is wrong with you? She's my wife!
Beast, listen to me! There's nothing going on! I'm
mad!
Hey!
Bastard! I guess I finally see you for who you are!
Stop! Stop it!
I knew you were sneaking around!
I don't want to hurt you, so just calm down and-
Beast!
Damn, bro.
What the hell do you think you're doing? You aren't even listening to me!
She's my wife, Bigby! You don't want to see this.
God damn. Like a ritual happening here.
Shit.
What is it? Oh my god.
Don't touch anything.
Is this?
Lily met her client here. Mr. Smith, whoever he is.
And then?
Must have happened right here.
Jesus.
Last night?
Yeah.
I was probably
on her period.
Night.
Destroyed the shit out of her.
Beauty.
It's like, nah.
What?
I'm not a prostitute, you idiot. I work the front desk.
So that's...
Do you remember who rented this room last night?
I don't think anyone did. Not last night. Maybe they have it long term. I don't know. How am I supposed to know? It just
you seemed employed
like a totally
here.
Normal night. How is that even possible? There's so much blood.
Go lock the front door. Keep people out of the hallway. I need you to be sure no one comes in here. This is a crime scene, okay?
But...
Just do what he says. I'll explain later, okay?
Yeah, cover your damn blood out of your eyes. How the fuck can you see out of squeezing the fucking Bigby, nails in your own?
What kind of a person could do something like this?
That's exactly what I'm about to try to find out.
I can't believe this.
Do all the rooms have these same clocks with the built-in cassette player?
I think so, yes.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to see in the other room then.
Where'd you get that?
Lily had it in her hand, in case there was any doubt over who died here.
We shouldn't even be in here. What is that?
It's a book about Snow White. Or about the Mundy version of her story, anyway.
You can't even read that. Beautiful.
The whole book is about her?
Yeah.
Fuji, Red Delicious, Empire?
Was she breathing? Why is she in a glass coffin?
This is the part where she's in a deep sleep, but they think she's dead.
What's it mean? Why mark the page where she's sleeping?
I think he marked this page because he likes the sight of a helpless person. It's about power for our Mr. Smith. He likes to be in control.
Maybe what the hell? Like he can't deal with people when they're awake? That makes him some kind of crazy, insecure deviant.
Can't wake
Maybe
up.
Maybe he killed her just because she woke up. Jesus.
I don't even know if I was right. Is there anything else?
It's a huff and puff.
I thought you were the only one who smoked that crap brand.
Apparently not. He brought wine.
Classy. God.
Look, the same wine, what's his name, the guy has for my arrival. Oh god. When I actually play it. No, before I do that, listen here.
Someone's been rough with this dress. It's torn.
Oh no. She must have been wearing it. He killed her and then he took it back off.
Oh, and probably switched
his smell. There's no blood on it. It must have been torn some other time.
What are you thinking?
This is the same dress as the one in the book about snow. I think Smith was dressing Lily up in it to recreate the snow from the book.
You're right. It's the same dress. So this freak made that poor girl dress up like Snow White, then cut her head off. She couldn't have known. She probably just needed the money. She could have been anyone. How did she wind up here? I mean, not exactly here, but just how does a person...
Maybe she made
sounds like there was a series of choices involved. I'm sure she'd have done things differently if she knew where things were headed.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Right, I think that's...
She must have been so scared.
Bro, some Disney music. Sing that. Kills
her. This? I think I heard this music last night. It was playing pretty loudly for a while and then stopped in the middle. I didn't think twice about it at the time. I mean, you hear all kinds of things around here, and I guess I've already gotten used to blocking them out.
Could have covered up the sound of the murder.
Maybe she didn't see it coming.
Da, na, na, na. What do I talk to you for?
Is there anything else you can tell me about last night? Anything that sticks out in your mind?
Sorry, no. It just seemed like every other night does. That's exactly what's bothering me. From now on, I'll just be down there imagining this.
How can I find out who rented this room?
Find whoever has the key? I'm pretty sure this one must be held long-term. And we don't keep a register or anything. This place is intentionally kind of anonymous.
Yeah,
I keep hearing that.
Basically go to the locksmith and just do that.
I'd better not find out you're hiding something from me about all this.
What the hell is wrong with you? I'm not involved in this!
Better not.
Please, just do whatever you need to do and let's get out of here.
Alright, so what else do I need to do?
Damn it, get it together, Beauty.
Oh.
Be
Whoa,
strong.
Oh, it's an apple?
Do you smell something?
No, just apple.
Oh no, there's more? What? What now?
It's got a single bite taken out of it, like in Snow's story.
Oh no, do you think it was poisoned?
It wasn't. I'd have smelled that. I think it's just a prop. It's here because they were acting out the scene in the book.
Of course.
It's murder.
That makes perfect sense. He's just acting out another part of the book. God, I'm just having trouble processing all of this. This guy has some kind of weird snow obsession, but then there's this other stuff, too. Apparently he enjoys helpless women. That's not going to bode well for anybody. I hope you're just about through. I don't really want to stay in here any longer.
Did you drop the apple? Oh my gosh, why is the music getting loud?
Are those pictures of the dead girl?
Not all of them.
How do you know?
I'm in this one.
If why do you look like in the mirror?
Winter.
Oh no. Bigby. This kind of stalking, it doesn't just stop by itself. Trust me, I know about this firsthand. He'll keep trying to get
Look, it's
closer
in the mirror again.
And closer.
Uh-oh.
His stand-in for Snow is gone now, so...
The next step closer. What is it?
It's... Crane.
Oh, shit. What the fuck? Alright, dude.
No respect for the dead.